classes. In our previous class, we have studied the characteristics of living and non-living things. Today, in this class, we shall just discuss them briefly. First of all, what we have discussed is living things need food, living things need air, living things reproduce, living things have special characteristics like breathing, and so many things we have discussed in our previous class. In today's class, we shall discuss one by them in a very brief manner. First, we shall discuss about living things need air. Do you think air is essential for living things to breathe? Yes, it is very essential for living things to breathe, because if there is no air in the surrounding, the human beings or any other living things will die. Living things have special organs for taking in air and giving out air. All the living things, not only human beings, all the living things which are having that specialized characters which we have discussed in our last class, which all the things which are having all those characteristics have a special organs for breathing. Or what is this breathing? Is taking in air and giving out air. Especially human beings, two types of airs are used for breathing. First one is oxygen, which is very essential. Second one is carbon dioxide. Okay, well, we should all know that, as I told you many times, human beings take in oxygen and gives out carbon dioxide. For example, if I am doing like this, I am taking in oxygen. If I leave out the air which I have taken inside, that air which has come out is carbon dioxide. But in only one special case, that is in plants, that too, while the process of photosynthesis is going to take place, the plants take in carbon dioxide and gives out oxygen. Did you understand? Only in the time of photosynthesis, plants take in carbon dioxide and gives out oxygen. So what? We should plant more plants so that we human beings or other living organisms except plant can get sufficient amount of oxygen to breathe and to maintain our health. Very good. Now, we shall, as I told you, breathing is a process where human beings take in air and gives out air. For this process, human beings use lungs, especially nose, where from the nose we take in and we leave out. What do we take in is, we take in oxygen and gives out carbon dioxide, as we are all human beings. Grasshoppers have a tiny spores. What is tiny spores? A little spores like this, which help them to take in oxygen and gives out carbon dioxide, because grasshopper is an animal, it is not a plant. Okay? So what? It takes in oxygen and gives out carbon dioxide, where it helps, it is used, it helps spiracles, which are known as tiny spores, to breathe. Aquatic animals. What are these aquatic animals? Is fish, shark, octopus, and many other things which we are all seeing in water or underwater. Such organisms are called as aquatic organisms or aquatics. They use gills, where human beings use nose, grasshoppers use spiracles, aquatic animals use gills. I told you little before, plants even breathe, where they take carbon dioxide and gives out oxygen with the help of tiny spores like grasshoppers. In grasshoppers, they are present in the leaf. They are called as stomata, which are tiny spores which help them for breathing. Yes, my dears, I will repeat it once. Breathing is a process where they take in oxygen. The human beings or the living organisms except plant take in oxygen and dissolve carbon dioxide, but plants take in carbon dioxide and dissolve oxygen. The special organs which are helpful for this breathing in humans is lungs, or especially nose, in grasshoppers, spiracles, aquatics, gills, plants, stomata. These are all the organs which are modified in the human beings or in the living organisms to breathe. Okay, we have discussed about why characteristic of living being, that is living things, need air. We shall just discuss living things not only need air, living things even need food and water to survive. Living things even need food and water to survive. Well, food gives energy to human, to organisms. For what? For doing work. You write, you read, you listen to my class. It is because of you are taking in food which gives you energy to do anything. For example, if you have not eaten a food for many days, what will happen? Yes, you are not able, you are not willing to do anything, or you will not be able to do anything because there is no energy in your body. For example, you have taken a new bike. You should pour petrol into that so that it will run. If you are not pouring the petrol into the bike, does it run? No, it will not. Similarly, if bike which is prepared by human beings is not ready to run without some energy, how does the God made thing, human beings or living things, can do work without food or without getting any energy? Yes. So by this we can tell that all living things need food and water. All living things need food and water. Where healthy food keeps living things healthy. If you are not having healthy food, which you are having contaminated food, what it will happen? You will not get energy. The energy which is present in our body for so many days you have eaten, the food will lose. So what? We should eat healthy food so we can remain healthy. Similarly, we all know that human beings prepare food. Human beings prepare food. Does it prepare by its own? No. It takes the help of plant. For example, in your home you are cooking rice and sambar. The basic materials which are essential for cooking rice is rice, water, salt. These things are prepared by human beings? No. Rice is prepared from the plant, water is the natural resources, salt is also available from the water. For you have prepared rice. For preparing sambar, you use some leaf like spinach. Spinach is also the thing which is available from the plant. Dal, which is also we get from the plant. We get chili, we add chili powder or chili. So what we are, the things which we are preparing in our home, we call human beings prepare in our home in the help of plants. But we should know that plants don't need anyone to cook food or prepare food, because it cook food of its own. Sorry my dears, because plants cook food of its own with the help of some raw materials like sunlight, chlorophyll pigment and water, minerals and etc. With the help of all these things, plants prepare their own food. This process is known as photosynthesis. What is photosynthesis? Photosynthesis is a process where the green plants prepare their own food with the help. help of some raw materials like sunlight, water, minerals, and the chlorophyll pigment. This process is known as photosynthesis. Thus, the things which is taken by the plants to cook food is prepared by human beings. No, it prepares its own food. So, we can tell that plants prepare their own food, but human beings don't prepare their own food. Prepare their own food by the help of plants. However, and whatever food is food, which is very essential for all living organisms. That is what the characteristic of living organism is. What is the characteristic of living organism? Is living things need food and water. But, my dears, non-living things, for example, this chalk, does it need any food? If you are not giving this food, does it die? No. You keep this chalk piece for a day, for a month, or for a year. Does it die? Does it happen something? No, it will not happen something because it is a non-living thing where this is not having capability or capacity to take food, or which is not essential for this chalk to take food. So what? It is not having the capacity to prepare its own food or to prepare the food by using the help of some raw materials which is prepared by the plants. By this, we can tell that living things need food and water, but non-living things don't want any food and water to live or survive. Similarly, living things don't need any air to survive. It lives as it is if there is no air. Yes, by this we can tell that living things need food, water and air. This is what we have learned in our today's class. We shall just move on with our next characteristics of living organisms, which are essential for them and which are not essential for them in our next class. My dears, your homework is to write the characteristics of living organisms and you can write the difference between the difference characteristics between living and non-living organisms. Hope so, all of you do. Thank you.